हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पाठक्स कंप्यूटर एकेडमी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट बेसिक एचटीएमएल टैग्स। टुडे वी विल सी द टैग्स दैट कैन बी यूज्ड इन द फॉर्मेटिंग ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट दैट आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्प्लेड इन योर वेब पेज। सो टुडे वी विल सी द टैग्स रिलेटेड टू द फॉर्मेटिंग ऑफ द टेक्स्ट and font tags. Let's start. Whatever you can achieve in Microsoft Word while writing your text, that can be achieved in HTML also. So, first tag that is known as bold tag. Sometimes you need the reader's attention at a particular sentence or word. Then this B tag can be used. Other than this, a strong tag is also used to achieve this same functionality. Next one is italic tag. Italic tag is used to display the text at a slight angle. Okay. And basically these are used when your web page have some technical terms or idioms, etc. This I tag can be replaced with the EM tag also. EM means emphasize. If you want to emphasize on some words or sentence, then this tag can be used. Next one is underline. If you want to put underline on a particular sentence of your web page, then U tag can be used. One thing you have to be noted down that HTML tags are already underlined and don't need the extra tag. Okay. Here the example, you can see that whatever you want underline, then you have to put that word or sentence under U tag. Okay, here. Next one is strikeout. Strikeout means the text have some line in between. And these type of text are used when some functionality you have to show that are deprecated or that are obsolete, old one. Then strike tag can be used. Other than this, you can use the same thing with the help of del tag. Okay. You have to put the whole sentence or word under strike tag, or this can also be worked with the help of only S tag. So here I have you chosen S tag. Okay. Next one is pre-formatted text. I already discussed in the previous lecture that web browser does not support white spaces. Like new line, tab button, or even space. And if you want to include that white spaces, or if you want to include some formatted text that should be looked as same as what I have written in the source code, then that formatting should be kept in pretest. Otherwise, it will not shown on the web browser. Okay. Next one is superscript. Superscript tag are generally used in mathematics formula like pi r square. So here square should be printed just over the r or radius. So here what will happen? Pi r square is shown as like this. Pi into radius r, and then 2 will be shown just above the r, pi r square. The same thing as subscript, and this subscript are generally used in chemistry formula like H2SO4, H2O, where 2 are shown just below the normal text. Okay. Next one is small. If you want to show some word or sentences much smaller than the normal one, then small tag can be used. Abbreviation. Abbreviation means if you want to disclose or show the full form or acronym of a particular word, whenever your mouse hover on that text, then ABBR tag is to be used, and in ABBR you have to include a property known as title, where you have to put the full form of particular word that you want to show in your web page as a tool tip. Okay. Clear? Next one is mark. If you want to highlight some text or sentence, then that word should be kept under mark tag. Next one is meter. Again, in the web page, you want to show some range value. That, for example, speed of a bike. Okay. So there are mainly 3 attributes that you have to be included: min, max, and value. Other than this, there are 2 more attribute can be used, high and low. And based on low and high, the color of the range is shown. If the value between the low and high, then it will show green, otherwise it will show yellow and red. Next one is quotation. If you want to highlight some quote over the web page, then Q tag can be used. So these are text formatting tags. Now I am going to discuss font tag. Why? Because font tags is used in text. Which type of text you want to be taken, which color of text you want to be shown, and which size you have to be taken. But nowadays in HTML5, these are not supported. Why? Because of other functionality that can be achieved with the help of CSS. Okay. So First one is font size. So there are values from 1 to 7 that can be used. And by default size is 3. Okay. So the size of the text will shown as per the size you have given as an attribute in font tag. Okay. Next one is font type. It's just like a face attribute. Okay. That can be New Times Roman, Arial, Courier, and whatever you have installed in your computer. That can be included over here. Like face attribute is equal to Wordana. Size is equal to 6. So Pathak's Computer Academy will shown in Wordana font and size is 6. And at last, color, as same as I have discussed when I told you how to change the background color of your web page, the same thing can be used while writing your text. And that can be achieved by some by default value are overloaded over in HTML like red, yellow, green, or hexadecimal value like this. This is the hexadecimal value of green. Or you have to give RGB value because we are using a sky value format that you have to put 0 to 255 RGB. Three value you have to be given for red, green and blue because you know that with the help of these three color you can create any other color in the world. So that's all for today. I'm going to show you all these tags in my source code that I already written over here. Here you can see that I have taken B for bold, I for italic, U for underline, S for strong, okay, pre for preformatted text, SUP for superscript, SUB for subscript. Then here you can see that pi into radius and 2 will shown just over the radius. And here H, after that 2 shown just below the H, and then O will displayed as by default. And after that, this smaller will shown much smaller than the size of the by default size of web page. Next one is abbreviation I have taken. So hypertext markup language will shown whenever I move my mouse over where HTML is written. After that, I have written that highlight word will be shown in highlighted form. Again, I have chosen meter. Meter will shown a range. And the color, what will be the color will be shown? Because I have given the value 60 and 60 is between low and high, it should shown green value. After that, I have taken quotation as Q. And after that, I have chosen the size, font size, 3, 4, 5, face, and then color. Okay. Here you can see that. I am going to refresh that page. Here, my web page is loaded, some words are in highlighted form, some words are in italic form, some words are underlined. This is for what? This is for deprecated form that can be achieved with strikeout. This is pre-formatted tag. This is superscript. This is subscript. This is a smaller word is shown with the help of small tag. Now, HTML, I am going to move my mouse over here. Here you can see a tooltip. What is the tooltip? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. After that, the highlighter, and then the range. Green signal is over here. If I have given the value more than the high, let's see 80. So you can see what will happen. The color will change. Refresh. Here you can see that a yellowish color is shown. Now, Modi is our inverted comma. A quotation is to be kept here. Now, my font size, small, normal one, 3, then 4, then 5, as written over here, 3, 4, and 5 size. And then Pathak Computer Academy is written with the type of Vardhana and size is 6. And after that, Himanshu Pathak is written in green color. So, when you design your web page, you can format your text accordingly as per your need. So I think now it is very clear to you how could you change or how could you format your text that are going to be represent or displayed as a content of your web page. In the next class, we will start or we will learn image, how we can include an image on the web page, links, how could we move from one page to another page, and list tag. Okay, like Microsoft Word. For example, 1, 2, 3, if I want to list it as number or alphabet ABC or Roman 1, 2, 3. So that will be in the next lecture. Thank you so much.